Okay, let's go ahead and start. Hello, everyone. Welcome to today's C2BH Turkey's webcast, Future Design Trends in Construction. I'm pretty sure it will be very enlightening one with expert matters from around the globe. First of all, I would like to give a brief information about Council on Tall Buildings and Urban Habitat for the ones who may not know. I'm representing C2BH for Turkey with İlay Döner as well as Mehmet Sakin and Burak. The Council on Tall Buildings and Urban Habitat is the world's leading resource for professionals focused on the inception, design, construction, and operation of tall buildings and future cities. Trends indicate that the world's cities must accommodate an additional 2.5 billion people by 2050. But the way that this growth emerges is still up for debate. Through a myriad of exciting initiatives, the Council is providing guidance to the shapers of our urban landscapes with the goal of enabling smarter, more sustainable cities and more viable future for global populations. We disseminate multidisciplinary information on tall buildings and sustainable urban environments to maximize the international interaction of professionals involved in creating the built environment and to make latest knowledge available. The C2BH is a non-profit organization that has also developed the international standards for measuring tall building heights and recognize superior achievement in tall and urban building projects globally through the C2BH Awards program. C2BH developed internationally accepted criteria for measuring tall buildings heights and are recognized as the arbiter for bestowing such designations as world's tallest building. And C2BH is not an organization who advises to build high rises. People may have that kind of understanding. Also, for this event, BIM for Turkey helped us out, also one of our sponsors, Building Information Modeling and Management Association. We would like to thank them as well for helping us on this. And BIM for Turkey is the center of transformation for the construction industry in Turkey. It aims to facilitate the integration of building information modeling and management easier and smoother to the construction industry, higher education, and public companies. Having said that, the coronavirus pandemic has changed everything, as you all know. Its impact on global wellness and the economy has forced organizations in every industry, including our own, to flex and evolve, both in real time and in long term. In this collection of ideas, tips, thoughts, and strategies, we explore how design can play a role in making the world a healthier place. That's why we are starting our webcast right now. I'm turning to my colleague, my partner in this business, Mehmet Genç, to take over and moderate this webcast. Enjoy, please. Thank you.
Hi, everyone. Welcome. Mehmet, thank you for the great introduction. I think it is always very helpful go through the mission of CTBUH and how they are guiding and structuring tall buildings around the world. I think we have a great agenda for you today with many valuable people and best what they do in their business. Again, hi everyone. I'm Mehmet Genç, operations manager as project director on Ziraat Towers project Turkey with Turner. For the most part, I worked in the United States for some time, a little over 10 years, and then another almost 10 years in Turkey right now on the project management side of our company, Turner Construction. Once again, our topic today is discussing potential impacts of COVID-19 pandemic and concerns on designing structures in the future and on certain existing property structures. We want to thank again to CTBUH as well as BIM for Turkey for enabling us to have this platform to conduct these informative webinar sessions. towards the end of the webinar, folks, you're going to have an opportunity to ask questions. You can throw your questions during the webinar. We will be collecting them. And we are going to have an open session with questions and answers towards the end of the webinar. I encourage you to think of some questions if you haven't already done so and throw them out there. And with our great guest speaker, we will try to address them. We do have very distinguished guest speakers today. One of the best, if not the best, at what they do at exceptional international design firms. They're guiding and leading the industry with innovations and their work. They're our friends. They're very humble people. We like them a lot. We like working with them. And we really appreciate them spending time with us today, allocating some of their quality time for this webinar. These folks designed and worked on high quality variety of structures, commercial, residential, mixed use, hotels, shopping malls. So I would like to welcome each one of you again and thank you for your participation. We always take pride. We really, you know, you guys really make us proud to have such a company in Turkey. Being able to keep up with international designs and work on these large projects with the well-known architects like the ones we have on the online today. So you guys, many companies had to exercise, that includes us actually, of course, to minimize the risk, such as social distancing arrangements in the offices, online meetings utilizing programs such as Zoom, that we all use right now, Microsoft Teams. For the efforts of minimizing travel, if not completely eliminating it for a certain time period. You are all leaders in key international design firms. I think a lot of folks would be interested in to hear your experiences during the pandemic period, limited travel. How did you conduct your business with travel restrictions? Any key items you can think of you learned from it moving forward? Perhaps use of time for meetings with limited travel came to realize meetings at different locations could be more productive with the assist of online tools. So how did you manage your teams during this? I mean, you guys were somewhat prepared for this pandemic and lockdowns and restrictions because you already practiced online and long distance business styles with your clients as well as I would figure. I think that Many industries are learning from this pandemic and the way that they conduct their business, the way that they hold their meetings, and everything is going to have some changes. I think a lot of people are learning from this and developing some better procedures as they can. I personally think that almost no one was prepared for this type of pandemic. No one in life today, right now, has probably never experienced something like this in their lifetime. And no industry was fully prepared for this pandemic. Many difficult decisions quickly needed to be made, having to consider many perspectives, the economic impact to the countries, normal order of life, right, to protect of society, security of the cities, and most importantly, the human lives. Organizations, companies had to take quick actions, short-term solutions at their facilities, properties, such as adding, extending partitions, organizing, reorganizing restrooms, elevators, escalators, modified meeting rooms. They could not consider, any aesthetical look of their properties because perhaps the millions of dollars and funds that they spent on the design of their existing properties, they couldn't care. They just needed to act fast and take actions, precautions to protect human lives. So as we continue to learn from this pandemic, and when there's actually time to design for it, the structures, what changes, potential requests, possible code changes, do you foresee designing future projects in different markets? End user occupant expectations. Just a quick reminder, folks, you can throw in your questions as we speak and continue with the webinar. So as you continue to ask questions, we will be going through them towards the end of the webinar. Indeed, the service businesses, specifically small businesses, service businesses are one of the most impacted ones during this pandemic. Brandon, this question is for you. Due to the pandemic, again, many developers, property owners have been having to make changes to their office space layout, as we discussed, common use areas, public spaces. Manufacturing industry making adjustments to their production lines to, again, maintain a healthy environment for their workers. Hospitality industry, hotels are rearranging their spaces to the level of their beach setup, but they're arranging their beaches to promote a healthier environment for their clients, for their customers. So to that end, how the COVID-19 pandemic could change the existing, already built structures? Are you expecting retrofit requests, redesign interior spaces of the existing properties? What are the client end user requests for ongoing design works do you have? Are you modifying design on your ongoing works? That's I wonder about that. Are you modifying anything on your ongoing works? You briefly touched on it. And with social distancing, space is going to be even more valuable in the properties, especially in the metropolitan cities. It is for sure. And I'll tell you, Brandon, you touched on it, and I'm going to get to that next, actually, with Mehmet Okutanbey. People have been extremely concerned about, including myself actually, using the elevators to get to their apartments, condos in the high-rise or mid-rise buildings, because there has been a lot of also comments and speculation when it comes to use of the elevators. These air particles can hang in the air, and even if you are riding the elevator yourself, you may still be infected. So I'm curious about the thoughts of potential vertical redesign in the future. I'm going to be talking to Mehmet Okutan on that as we continue. Niall, it is said that this pandemic is also changing the preferences of people on their home type selections. There's now more demand on the low-rise to mid-rise apartment buildings. People are seeking, for sure, more interested into having a garden space or a terrace or a balcony in their areas, and people will be less inclined to live in the high-rise buildings. Of course, this relates to the type of city people live in, but primarily for metropolitan cities. What design and usage changes do you anticipate, especially on the high-rise buildings? And very common question that we have been actually hearing during this pandemic is, are operable windows in high-rise buildings, is it a good thing to do, pros and cons of it, or is it a bad thing to do? Your preferences. I think you may have a couple slides that you want to show on this. But yeah, what do you think about operable windows on the high-rise buildings, especially? I personally, like many people, actually fresh air. It's always my preference to have fresh air, no matter how high the building is. But yeah, it needs to be thought out and designed very carefully to avoid permanent future problems on the structures. Mehmet Okutanbey, the engine of the buildings, I call it myself, the mechanical systems of the buildings. Many people became more sensitive to and worried about the interior air quality in their properties. Risks with the existing AC systems and the setup, how the COVID-19 pandemic changed the existing already built structures, what can be done on already built MEP systems. What is needed for better interior air quality considering a virus pandemic? Yeah, I wanna start off with I'm actually very interested in like what can be done to improve the quality of the air in the existing buildings when it comes to MEP mechanical system. And again, I actually do expect on this like high qualified buildings around the world, people will be a lot more considering to changing some of their existing MEP systems. So that could be another that could be another business line perhaps for some of the companies. Actually, I think I want to quickly turn back to Niall about the elevators again. When it comes to like trying to minimize the potential such a virus in the elevators, Niall, it could come to type of material selections, perhaps minimizing the touching on the buttons in the elevators, voice activated systems more in the future. Now I want to go into our questions and answers session. We have a question from Mr. Burhan Şirin. Great to hear from you, Mr. Burhan. Thank you for participating as well. Let me look at your question here. Brandon, perhaps you can respond to this if you could. So Burhan says, more shared spaces, more common grounds, less density are rarely what many developers ask for. Of course, the space is very valuable. He's right. Do you think the market would adapt itself to the demands of such pandemic? So without building regulation and codes. So no regulations, no codes, but perhaps thinking on the human side of part of the minds of the developers, he's asking, do you think people would incline to do such things and utilize social distancing and sacrifice perhaps some of their valuable space? I think this is what he's saying. Do you expect any tendency in the local authorities in that direction? So government regulations, CDC, Center for Disease Control, perhaps is even further adaptable spaces, modular spaces that is flexible for adjustments. People, I am sure people will be more considering that type of spaces in their, you guys will be assisting them to implement their thoughts. Mr. Hakan Hazneci, we have a question from you. Hakan Hazneci Bey is referring this question to Mehmet Okutan Bey. Mehmet Okutan Bey, he's asking, which type of buildings will encounter more dramatic changes during and post-pandemic era? Your thoughts on, anybody else, gentlemen, who wants to also answer, of course answer, but he's asking if it is institutional, industrial, healthcare, commercial, hospitality, etc. Your thoughts on starting off with Okutan Bey, which again market sector in the construction industry would get impacted with this pandemic. We have a question from one of the valuable vertical transportation consultants, Yavuz Kaya is asking a question about the vertical transportation design. He's saying that there are some features which are using for better traffic and security purposes, like cargo, artificial intelligence control system, destination control at lift lobby, etc. At the moment, he's saying, we believe that features will be requested more, but a standard feature, he's thinking. Also, we had to use the features which comply the standards and regulations. For example, touchless button is not accepted as per disabled standard. So having said all this, he's asking to Niall and Brandon, when designing the vertical transportation systems, what priority do you give? What priority do you give to vertical transportation design to the extent you can expand on? All right, so reviewing the questions here. My question, Mujahid Bilal Göker Bey. He's got a question for you, Brandon. He has worked for nearly all the companies, he's saying. He's asking for an advice. He's saying, what advice can you give the young architects that are watching right now? Now, another question about the homes people live in. Do you think that homes will be designed with being used as an office also in consideration? Do you think there could be such a market segment where people are utilizing their homes, residential buildings, and flexible to quickly adapt to an office space also is the question. We have a question from Sergei Yuchenko. He's asking, Brandon, you might want to answer this one. Has your approach to feasibility studies requested by clients changed in light of COVID-19? Feasibility studies requested by clients, have they changed due to COVID-19? Is that, for example, he's saying, do your clients feel compelled to explore different occupancy densities as they are crucial in determining projects' profitability? People and organizations, firms, would definitely want to be better prepared. God forbid there's a future pandemic like this, but yeah, preparation is the key. People want to be more prepared. We have a question from Dilek Inge. Dilek Inge says, thank you all for this productive, stimulating webinar. As an architect, she's an architect, I start to imagine some new materials could be brought to market after this crisis. Mehmet Okutan Bey, she's saying. See, she's asking, my question is kindly to Mehmet Okutan if possible. I recently start to see HypoClean technology provided as a household equipment. So HypoClean technology and household equipment. She's asking Mehmet Okutan Bey, can this be adapted to mechanical ventilation system? So HypoClean technology and mechanical ventilation system, is that possible, is her question. We have a graduate student civil engineer question, Cihat Özeray. I actually do like this question. It's I think many people has this in their minds. The during lockdown, he's saying no one was allowed to use public spaces, although some people need them for fresh air. On the other hand, when the measures are taken down, large groups of people seem to abuse the opportunity to create risk for other people. Do you see a way of utilizing parks for regular use? Do you see those areas getting more personalized? He's referring to areas around the residential buildings in metropolitan cities, I think. So when it comes to landscaping design and things like that, more personalized design for these public spaces, greenery areas around the buildings. So it's been a great seminar, very informative seminar. Thank you so much for your time. We really appreciate you taking the time again out of your very busy schedules. I was talking with my colleagues. I have been talking with my colleagues. When people are working in the remote location, sometimes it actually becomes, turns into a very lengthy conversation and makes it very difficult to catch up with the phone calls and emails like that. You have been industry leaders and I think it's not very common to have industry leaders when it comes to design, to have them together and talk about the common topics and common goals. We all know that many things will never be the same as it was before the pandemic in various industries. I think we discussed some of the possibilities today in the construction and design industry specifically. Again, thank you so much, Niall.
All right. Well, we wish everyone healthy days.
Take care of all your friends, families, and your coworkers for us. Thank you so much. Have wonderful and healthy days, everyone.